Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I hope you all will be fine. Now in today's video, I'll explain some paragraphs from the second part. So please watch this video very carefully. Now look at the paragraph number first of the second part. Mridu crept to the window. Lali was sitting a little distance away, awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring, her elbows jutting out and her eyes glazed with concentration. In front of her, with most of his back to the window, was a bony figure of music master. He had a mostly bald head with a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears and an old-fashioned tuft. A gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck and a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it glided up and down the stem of the violin. A large foot stuck out from the beneath his gold-bordered vested edge, and he was beating time on the floor with the scrawny big toes. As you have already learned about the first part, now in second part you will see that when they heard the weird sound of violin that was coming from the window where Lali was playing violin very poorly. So, all three closed to the window and peeped into the room to see what Lali was doing inside. So, Mridu walked up to the window very slowly. Lali was sitting a little distance away from the window, facing the window. She was holding the violin and bowstring, it means string of violin. Bowstring means strings of violin. In an awkward manner. Miss Mridu was holding the violin in an awkward manner. Her elbow was coming out and there was lots of concentration and focus in her eyes to learn to play the violin. She was trying hard to learn to play the violin. And the music master was sitting in front of Lali. His back was towards Mridu as Mridu and her cousins were standing behind the window. Now they are describing the music teacher. He was a bony figure. Bony figure means thin man and had oiled hair. Hair locks on the side of ear. I mean the music master was very thin man and he had old hair and hair locks on both sides. And also there was a little amount of hair on his head that was tied up in a tuft. Tuft means choti. The music master tied his hair in a tuft behind his head. And the music master also was wearing a gold chain that was shining from his leathery neck. Leathery neck means lines or fold on the neck. Some elder people had some lines and fold on the necks. They had no smooth neck. So those kind of necks are called leathery neck. And also the music master had a diamond ring in his finger that was shining when the sun rays fell on it while playing the violin. The music master was wearing a vested means dhoti with a golden border while sitting with a cross legged. Means the old man, the music master was wearing dhoti and it was gold bordered and he was sitting with a cross legged. Was putting one leg on another leg and he was placing his thin feet on the floor to calculate the rhythm. It means he was putting his leg on the floor on the earth to calculate the rhythm from time to time. Now look at the paragraph. He played a few notes. Lali stumbled behind him on her violin which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hand. What a difference! The music master's note seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the visible tracks of the melody. It was like a wheels of train fitting smoothly into the rails and whizzing along. As Ravi said, Mridu stared at the huge bearinged hand moving effortlessly up the violin stem, making lovely sound. Swag. There was Lali derailing again. Amma came a wail from the gate. Amma, oh. So in this paragraph it is told that when music master played some notes, Lali trying to learn and to produce the sound, but Lali every time stumbled behind him. It means she was playing the violin and every time she produced a very poor sound. She was struggling hard to play the violin and to match the notes. It seemed like violin looked helpless and happy in the Lali's hand because there was a huge difference between the way music master and Lali was producing music. When the music teacher was playing it, and so he produced very beautiful sound and music. And every time when Lali was trying to play, it was like a train had gone off the track completely. It produced a very strange and weird music. And when music master was playing the violin, it was sounds like a train is moving on very smoothly on its track. But Lali every time missed the track and produced a very poor sound. She could not match up her teacher. Swag. Lali again derailed from the track. While Lali was trying to play the violin and to match the rhythm, then by that time a wail means a cry or sound of grief came from the gate. Amma, amma. Now look at the paragraph. Ravi sent the beggar away, cried his mother from the back veranda where she was chatting with Happy. He has been coming here every day for the past week, and it's time he found another house to beg from, Pati explained to Tapi. So when the beggar shouted from the gate, Amma, Amma, please give me something to eat. So his mother, Ravi's mother, was chatting with Tapi and another family member in the veranda. She shouted from there, Ravi, send the beggar away. He has become a regular visitor, comes every day for the last weeks, and also ask him to find different house to beg. Ravi's mother explained all the matter in front of Tapi and other family members. She asked Ravi to send the beggars away and to find another house to beg. Now look at the paragraph. Mridu and Meena followed Ravi out. The beggar was already in the garden, making himself quite at home. He had spread his upper cloth under the neem tree and was leaning against his trunk, apparently prepared to take a little snooze while he waited for the arms to appear. Go away, said Ravi sternly. My Pati says it's time you found another house to beg from. So Ravi was told to send the beggar away from the house, but Mridu and Meena also went out with him, and the beggar was already sitting in the garden, feeling comfortable like in his own house. He spread his cloth, upper cloth, means rumal, etc. So he spread his cloth in a shade of neem tree. He was trying to have some rest for some time. By that time, Ravi reached there and said very strictly, "Go away. My Pati says it's enough now. Now find another house for food. You are coming from 1 week. Now get out from here. We have nothing to give you. Now search another house to beg." Now look at the paragraph. The beggar opened his eyes very wide and gazed at each of the children one by one. "The ladies of this house," he said at last, in a voice choked with feeling, "are very kind souls. I have kept my body and soul together on their generosity for a whole week. I cannot believe that they would turn me away." He raised his voice, "Amma, Amma, oh," said his wail might be, but it certainly wasn't feeble. It began in a deep, strong rumble somewhere how in his withered belly, and came teeth stained brown with a bitter chewing. And came booming out of his mouth with its few remaining teeth stained brown with bitter chewing. So when Ravi said, "Go away, my Pati have ordered you to find another house for begging," so the beggar opened his eyes very wide and was feeling so sorry for himself. He looked very helpless at those children one by one and said, please do something for me. I don't know where to go and how to find the house and how to find the food for eating. I have been surviving for last week because of the charity provided by your mother and your grandmother. They are very kind soul. Soul means human being. And only because of their charity I am alive. I cannot believe that they ask me to go away from this house and find another house. So again, the beggar shouted very loudly, "Amma, Amma, please give me something to eat." He shouted so loud, and in his sound there was a sign of sadness in his voice, but there was no weakness. It means his voice or his sound was very strong, and in his stomach, empty and dull stomach, somewhere started a deep sound, and also you could see see his teeth was bordered with red. It means there was some red spot on his teeth, and those spots were only because of chewing the betels. This is your today's lesson. Thank you very much for watching this video.